Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the minimum and the maximum value present in a column in MySQL using Node.js. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a sample code for posting data by using Node.js in MySQL. So if you want this code, you can just pause the video and type it out. It's just like a basic and standard stuff over here. So here is the post function, and this is my table over here, which has like three columns: ID, name and mark. So you can also like type this out in your MySQL workbench, and basically you can also type this code in your Visual Studio code as well. So once you're done with the post function, now I will be showing you how to find the minimum and the maximum value. So for this, we'll be using the get function, all right, because we are just going to fetch the minimum and maximum value. So it's like fetching the data. So for that, we'll be using app.get. So just come down the post function, and here I'm going to type app.get. And this app corresponds to this particular, all right. So I have also installed Express and MySQL packages, all right, these two. So let me come to, so it's app.get, and within bracket we are going to specify the path. So let me just go with get max. So this is for getting the maximum value, and it's just going to be the same thing again, request comma response and arrow function over here. So we are just going to write a query. There isn't going to be any request payload because we are just going to fetch data without any ID, all right? So it's going to be CON, which is my connection variable over here. So here it is, CON, and we'll be using the query function. So it's going to be query, and inside this we will be specifying our SQL query to find the largest value. So it's going to be select max function, and inside this you need to specify the column name for which you want to find the maximum value. So in my case, I'm going to find the maximum value present in my mark column. So let me just now run this particular table. So this is my table over here. So these are the values in it. So I'm going to find the maximum and minimum value for this particular mark column. So we need to specify the column name inside this particular max function. So it's mark, and we need to also like assign a name to the value that is the largest value that we are extracting from our table. So I will just go with as max mark like that, and then we need to use the from keyword from, and finally we need to use your table name. So my table name is my table, okay? So you need to just specify your table name over here. So my table, so this corresponds to this table over here. So that's good. And another important thing is that you need to specify this particular database over here as well. If you are using, like, be careful over that. Yeah. So I think this is the particular SQL query. So now we are good. So just come out of this particular single quote, and we will be having error, comma, result. All right. So just like a callback function. And so maybe let me just now come to the next line. Yeah, so this is now fine. So if you have space, you can just type it in the same line. It's just a continuation. So in case if you are having any error, let's just console.log that particular error. So yeah, this is fine. And in the else block, if you aren't having any errors, so let's just send that particular result as a response to our postman. So this will be appearing over here. So it's going to be response.send, and just type result. Yeah, so this is fine. So now we are done with our fetching the max value function. So let me just now save it. Let's just run and try it out. So it's going to be node filename.js. So it's on port 3000 and connected. So it has now started. So now we need to go to postman, and we need to go to none. Like, we are not going to send any data, and we need to change this to get. Really important thing, be careful here. And we need to specify the path. So it is slash get max. So I'm just copying it, and I'm just pasting it over here, slash. And if I just now send it, we need to get the maximum value present in our mark column. So the maximum value is 70. So we need to get the value 70 over there. So if I just now send it, so I will just scroll up. So here you can see I'm getting the max mark as 70. So this particular text, all right, is because of this particular text over here. So now let's see how we can access this value, because I think this is in a form of a raw data packet, I guess. So let me just now stop it, Control C to stop. And instead of sending it as a response, let me just console.log the result. So I'm just removing it and I'm just going to copy this and paste it. And I'm going to do result. Yeah, so let me just now save it and rerun it again. So it's on port 3000 again. So if I just now send it, so this time we won't be getting any response over here. But if I go to the console, so here we are having it as a raw data packet. So let me just show you how you can access this value. So for that, we will be using json.parse and json.stringify. It's just going to be a single line. So let me just have it like this. Let some variable, let me name it as data equal to, so it's going to be json all in caps dot parse, and within that we will be passing json dot stringify, and within that we will be passing our result. Alright, and in order to like directly access the value, what we can do is, okay, just replace it by data index of 0, just come outside of it, dot max mark. Alright, just copy this and paste it. So by using this particular two lines of code, at first we got some raw data packet, right? So now we will be just getting the value as 70. Just we will be getting the output only as 70. There isn't going to be any list or array or any JSON. We will be getting just the plain value in the console. So let me just now save it and I will just rerun it again. Yeah, it's connected. So if I just now go to my postman and again send it. Yeah, so this time you can see I'm just getting the raw data over here. So in case if you want the data with this particular key, you can just console this. You can just play around with that. It's your choice. So now let me also show you how to find the minimum value. It's just the exact same thing. To be honest, you can just copy this. So I will just copy this particular, wait, I will just copy this particular function and let me come down and paste it. So it's going to be get min, and I will be going with min. You just change all max to min. So yeah, min here as well. So I think this is fine for now. Yeah, let me just now save it and I will go with this particular path. Okay, let me just run it and go with the path. Yeah, I will copy this path now and I am going to my postman and just pasting it, and if I just now send it, yeah, so here you can see I am getting the value as 10. So if I just go to my table, so as you can see, this is the least value that I have in my table. So this is working perfectly fine. So the final thing what I wanted to show you was, what if you wanted the entire raw data of that particular minimum or maximum value? So what I want to say is that, so now we have got the minimum value as 10 and maximum value as 70, right? So what if you wanted the ID and name of that particular mark? So I want to get the data as 1, B and 70 in case I am trying to find the maximum value. And when I am trying to find the minimum value, I want to get the output as 4, D and 10. That is, I need to also get the values present in both these columns. So now I will show you like how to do that as well. So for this, it's just a simple query change, all right? I will just go to my getMax function at first. So it's going to be, you need to just add this line like before your existing query. So it's going to be select asterisk from your table name. This is my table name over here. And you need to use the where clause, column name equal to, and you need to just put the existing query within circular bracket. All right, just enclose the entire thing. So I think you won't be able to see it. Let me just now close this particular thing. Yeah, so this is the query. I think it's now clearly visible from the beginning to end. So what happens is that I think you'll be familiar with this particular command. Like we're just trying to access this particular row for this mark. So here what happens is that this will return basically the maximum value. So we will be just selecting the row with this particular mark. That is the max mark. I hope this made sense. It's just like a basic SQL query over here. So instead of doing all this stuff, I think this won't work now. So let me just now remove this. I am just going to like only print the data. All right. Yeah. So this is now fine, I guess. So let me just now save it and recompile it again. So this is fine. So let me just now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just copy this path and I'm going to go to my postman and just paste it. And I'm just going to send. And here you can see I've got ID 1, name B, mark 70. So I've got that entire row value over here. So this is fine. So now I will just show you the same exact same thing for min. I will just copy this. Yeah, this is the code. I will just paste it over here and just enclose the entire thing. Yeah, and I will go with this one, like data of 0. So this will be basically the first element. I won't be having this list. Okay, it will be just a plain JSON. So I'm saving it now. Okay. I'm saving it now. And if I just now rerun it again, so I need to go to get min this time, copying it and rerunning it again. Yeah, I just now send it. So you can see I've got ID 4, name D, mark as 10. So here is it, this particular entire row. So this is how basically you find the minimum and maximum value present in a column by using MySQL and Node.js. And I hope you have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming videos using MySQL, Node.js, MongoDB, C, C++, Java, React.js, as well as 3D animation using Blender. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.